What's up, y'all? It's Adanna. So I recently did a video not too long ago about do I sleep on a 24-hour shift, and I just kind of showed you a quick vlog of like a day in the life of a 24-hour shift, like on-call trauma PA. And so I know that it's a little bit hard to kind of grasp the concepts of everything, but the question was asked, like, how do my hours really work? And so that is what I'm going to be answering for you today. Adanna, welcome back to my channel. Okay, so I had this question asked by one of you all. And so again, if you haven't already done so, subscribe, leave your comments, like my videos, because it really, really helps out my YouTube algorithm. And so I will really appreciate it if you can do that. But Adriana Bevelacqua, I hope I said that right. She said, you mentioned patients may come in when you're about to get off your shift. How does that count towards your hours? Do you work less on the next shift? And so, I said that we are hourly. I work 72 hours essentially in a 14-day period, which equates to 3 24s. That's what we're obligated to work. Obviously, we can work more. We don't get your traditional overtime, so I don't get paid like time and a half or double time. If I go over my 72 hours, I just get paid my regular rate. And so when it comes to if there is a patient that is coming in while I'm about to come off, because it never fails, like literally it's maybe 7 o'clock in the morning, sign out for the patients from like the night before that we may have been seeing, or all of the patients that on the floor that we were dealing with, we would go to sign out and sign those patients out to the oncoming team at 7:30. So up until 7:30, like you're still essentially like the PA, right? You're the one that's still managing any new traumas that comes in. Because, you know, you can't expect people to take the shift that they're now coming in on. Like, it's not that it's expected, even though they still do it, okay? So I just want to make that clear. Like, we have a great team of trauma PA, so they help out, that we work really well together. But I just want to let you know that it's not necessarily like they have to be the ones that is taking this trauma. So if a trauma is called at 7:15, and I was in the trauma bay, or it's my turn to get the next trauma, like I have to run downstairs and start running this trauma. Now, like I said, the oncoming team will absolutely come in and help out, because they're going to be managing the trauma throughout the rest of the day once I go home. But no, like typically it starts off with me. Does that mean that I work less on the next shift? No, I'm there for 24 hours at a minimum, okay? At minimum, I'm there for 24 hours. So if I work, 27 hours on one shift, it doesn't mean that now I deduct that from my oncoming shift. I still work my full 24-hour shift on the next shift that I will have. And if I so happen to get off later or on time, then so be it. You know, I'll get paid for the time that I work. But it doesn't work that way in terms of like it's stickler for you only work 72 hours and that's it. Because you never know what can happen on a trauma call shift, okay? People do things, like some people do stupid things, some people just have accidents. And because of that, you have to be on call and you have to be ready and available. So thank you so much for asking me this question. But yeah, no, I don't get a shortened time. And honestly, I don't need it, because again, I'm only working 3 times in a 14-day pay period. Like, that's amazing, you know, and I love that. So I'm able to just kind of relax. If I have to work 28 hours one day and then I still get a full 5 days off, I'm good to go, okay? So I love it. So thank you so much, Adriana, for asking me that question. Again, leave me your comments and questions in the comment section below. Please, you guys, like this video. YouTube algorithm will love you for it. So will I. Follow me on Instagram at AdannaThePA. Go ahead and subscribe to this channel and follow me on Instagram at GetThatCUniversity as well. I will talk to you guys next time.